No matter what type of accounting system you're changing from, or what type of accounting system you're changing over to, the principles and ideas are the same, and I'm going to show you them in this little video series. There are basically two ways to change over to a new accounting system. Either you import your old data from the old system, or you do not import the old data from the old system. If you import your old data, then you should watch the videos on this very website about importing data. But whether you import or not, you must declare a start date for the new system, and all areas of data must match as of that particular start date. That means that for all of your books and records, as well as all of your reports, the balances at the end of the old system must be the same as the beginning balances of the new system at the moment you change to the new system. I recommend you start with no data import at all. The cleanest and easiest way is to use the old system to find transactions before the start date if you need to refer back to old transactions. Shortly after the transfer date, you will need the old system less and less. In fact, you could even do what we call a 1 month overlap. That means use both systems for 1 month after the conversion date. That will prove that everything is correct in the new system. But starting with no import does not mean that you will not do any data entry. You still must input into the new system any currently relevant transaction. And a currently relevant transaction is a transaction that will be used to make another transaction in the future. For example, open invoice. If you have an open invoice, you must use that invoice to record receiving payment against that invoice in the future. Same thing with a vendor's unpaid bill. You're going to make a bill payment in the future towards that bill. What about undeposited payments? You're expected to make a deposit later. Open purchase orders, same thing. If you had an open purchase order on the day that you transferred accounting systems, you're going to receive that order later. So you have to put that open purchase order into the new system. Any incomplete estimates for jobs with progress invoicing, they're not finished with the percentage of completion method. So they have to be put in from the beginning, and any transaction that relates to those estimates also has to be put in. So how do you fit it all together? Well, the numbers must match, and as I mentioned, the old system's ending numbers must be the same as the new system beginning numbers, not only for the same date, but here's the point, for all areas of data. Then the question is, what are the different areas of data that a company would have? Well, every company would have the general ledger and their results would go on the trial balance. But not every company would have accounts receivable and customer records. But if you do, the ending balances in the old system must match the beginning balances in the new system for the same date. Same thing with accounts payable, merchandise inventory, which you could always physically count. But if you're using the inventory module, it means you have records of the quantity that have to match the ending quantity in the old system to the beginning quantity on the date you switched to the new system. And of course, sales tax follows the same principles. But for our first example, we're going to start with a simple company that has no other areas of peripheral data except the general ledger. This company has no account receivable, no payables, no inventory quantity to track, and no sales tax. So an example of a simple company that you could do in the way I'm about to show you would be a corner store that simply has a cash register for the money coming in, deposits it into the bank every night, and writes checks from the bank account for the simple expenses that they have. In that case, a corner store only has a general ledger and nothing else. What about a cleaning service? They just show up and you write them a check, and sometimes they buy equipment, but they don't have any other area of financial data except their general ledger. Same thing with a delivery service and a repair service. Basically, any service that's usually done by a sole proprietor is a simple company that will only have a general ledger. Setting up one of those types of companies would be incredibly simple. All you have to do is make one big fat journal entry on the day that you transfer accounting systems. You will use the numbers from the old system's trial balance as of the declared setup date in order to make that journal entry. Here's an example of a typical trial balance. Of course, we will not be able to put in these three areas of peripheral data with our main journal entry. These three areas of data will have to be dealt with separately in future videos. But if we didn't have them, we could simply open up the general journal window in QuickBooks or any software that you're transferring over to and just make the same debits and credits that you see in the trial balance. That means any account listed on the debit side would have a debit in the one big fat journal entry, and any account listed on the credit side would also be credit in that big fat journal entry that you make to set up the company. And you could also do it in the journal entry window in QuickBooks Online. It does not matter what system you're transferring over to. If you only have a general ledger without receivables, payables, and inventory, it means you're finished after you make one journal entry that reflects the trial balance. Now for this course, let's call that the main setup journal entry, and I'm going to show you that at the end of the course. After we do the receivables and payables setup, we'll be ready for the main journal entry, because that's the way it would go in a real situation. So watch the receivables and payables video, then watch the exact actual video where we follow step by step and switch over to a new accounting system. I hope you enjoy the course, and I know you'll learn what you need to learn to switch over your accounting system.